to be able to do what we're doing, getting paid by various cities and schools and corporations to just to put our own message out there and be able to like beautify a certain area of the city. And so we started out vandalizing stuff, and now you know, we're cleaning up the city and really like making, I feel like in certain parts of Oakland and the Bay Area, just making a little bit of the difference of just making a corner just like look a lot better. And that's what people tell us, and so that's what we're doing. My name is Tim Hahn from Illuminaries, and I'm a graffiti artist.
I feel like graffiti is one of the means as to get to something bigger for him. It's an outlet, but I don't think it's the whole thing. And so I wouldn't consider him a muralist. Like, I'd never introduce him as, this is my brother, the muralist. Like, that's just something that comes along with who he is. And almost like a side note. Oh yeah, and he did that mural down the street. Oh, he did? I was like, yeah, he just, you know, on a weekend.
I'm just finding the matched color for the background. We're gonna just simple design, just make it like a, the whole theme is like a airplane hangar type thing. So we're gonna make these stripes kind of look weathered, like it's been chipped away, you know, it's like, So I'm just matching the gray color so I can come back and cut back into the white to kind of make it look like it's chipped out.
I actually met Tim probably senior year. He was going to a different school because he was in Fremont and I was in Newark. So we had a mutual friend, and our mutual friend was like, hey, I know this little crazy guy, Tim, man, he does graffiti and he smokes weed and all this. I was like, oh, I gotta meet him, you know? And when we first met, I just knew off the bat, like this guy, like we were gonna be friends. You know, he just had this certain energy to him. And then right after, I think a week or so after, we just started painting and doing graffiti illegally on the freeways. And I was like, all right, it's a good friendship. It's a good start right now, you know? We have Tim doing the freeway sign in Berkeley, and it was crazy. Like, he was painting it, I was climbing up. We had to climb over this razor wire. And then right when he was painting, there was police that came by right underneath.
It's been a long time since I've been chased by the cops. So that was like a fun experience, I guess.
Yeah. You know, can I add, what color did I get?
The black and the gray.
Is it white or gray?
Gray.
Okay. Can I add another, can you guys put another gallon of white?
People ask us like, what's your favorite? And it's so hard to say. It's kind of like, I would imagine, I don't have kids, but I would imagine it's like, what's your favorite kid? It's always the last one I work on is my favorite, because it's just so fresh in my mind. And the last one we worked on was for the Oakland Athletics, 95-foot wall, downtown Oakland. It was just, the process of it was just a beautiful thing for me. It just encapsulated everything about what I love about painting a mural. It's just so much involvement with people. Just meeting a lot of people. We met just dozens and dozens of people.
Lakin, who's our manager of marketing, over the winter, or it might have been last season actually, said, hey, you know, we should do a mural downtown. I'm like, all right, great, let's do it. Go find a wall, go find some artists, and let's go for it. So she went off, and by the fall, I think she had identified a few existing murals that she liked, and one of them was the Jam Tap mural and the Go Dubs mural that Illuminaries had done. And she said, I think, you know, these Illuminary guys are pretty cool.
I first found out about the Illuminaries walking downtown Oakland. I live down there, and there's a really good street art scene, and I enjoy it. I would see their work everywhere. And then they put up a new mural right downtown in Broadway, and they partnered with Visit Oakland, who I actually have a lot of friends that work there, so I reached out to them. Asked for the contact number for Illuminaries so I could get connected, and then went from there. I knew I wanted a mural in regards to design and what we actually put up there. I didn't know. I didn't have any like creative eye or design for it. I kind of just reached out to them and wanted to brainstorm and come up with an idea together, and that's kind of what happened. Gave them the creativity, the freedom to do what they wanted creatively, and then they pitched the idea and we went with the first one they pitched.
So, you know, we're gonna do a new variation of the Athletics mascot, this elephant stomper that really doesn't get a lot of attention. It doesn't, I don't know, I really don't really like the logo, so we're doing our own version. And so we thought about, you know, how do we give this thing more personality than just like an elephant with a baseball bat? So that's where the idea of the armor came about. And so I did a lot of research on the armor, and originally we thought about armor, and because of like the cat, we were gonna do like catcher's gear, right? Like baseball catcher's gear. He has like chest plate stuff, the face plate. So, but I was started looking up. I just went off on a tangent, and sometimes it's like late at night, I'm just like, I'm reading Wikipedia, and I'll just get stuck on tangent for like hours. So I was just reading about elephant armor and what it was used, and they'd been using elephants and as war horses for like 1,000 years before like 100 BC. And it's like a lot of cool stuff dealing with elephant armor, just chainmail and like spikes and all this stuff. Learning how to fly a plane, so that's something that's happening right now. I have about 30 hours in a little Cessna.
55, rolling, brakes, right rudder,
wobbling, big tires.
I was just listening to a podcast last night about how you're not supposed to call your color. You gotta do your full tail number. You just keep saying green tail dragger.
Oh yeah, I thought that was a little weird too.
So yeah, the inspiration for our art comes from a variety of places, and I think the result is what I'm looking at, and the result is always gonna be to uplift people, to make people smile, to make a space look better.
Okay, we're at 800 feet already, so, oh, AGL, so we'll give them a little space.